Just what is going on with the Haas livery for 2021? How's it going, everyone? I'm Wheaton, and today we're going to be talking about the VF21's livery for the 2021 Formula One season. Perhaps the most talked about car launch, but for all the wrong reasons. So, last week on March 4th, Haas released the VF21 for the upcoming season. That day, I was traveling, so I didn't get to see the release. Fast forward to Friday the 5th, and I'm seeing mainstream articles about the car. I thought to myself, what in the world is going on? After checking out the car, it is certainly not what I expected from a typical Haas livery. Well, it turns out WADA, or the World Anti-Doping Agency, recently banned Russian athletes from wearing the Russian Federation flag. This rang a bell, as I remember, an article that Nikita Mazepin will have to race under a neutral flag. So, is this a way of the billionaire boy to get his way, or is it related to their new title sponsor? Checking out the car again, I can certainly see the influence that the Russian flag has all over the car. If you don't know, the Russian flag is simply three horizontal stripes going from top to bottom, white, blue, and red. Looking at the front wing and the engine cover, it certainly looks like the Russian flag. Due to this, WADA has actually opened an investigation into the livery design. But what will come of the investigation? Certainly this livery is nothing of a typical Haas design, but it's probably just because of their new title sponsor, right? That's not quite the case. Aral Kali is a Russian fertilizer exporter owned by Dmitry Mazepin, Nikita's father. Taking a look at the company, its brand colors are red, white, and green, not blue. In fact, their website doesn't have blue anywhere to be found. This fact right here alone makes it seem like the design is catering toward Mazepin being able to show off the Russian flag even though it is banned. But will the livery be changed? Depending on the investigation of the World Anti-Doping Agency, it is certainly possible. In an interview, team principal Gunter Steiner said that the design had been created way before WADA had announced the ban on the flag. Further, there is a loophole that could keep the livery in its current form. WADA's ban only prevents Russian athletes from showing the flag. However, it does not ban the flag itself. And Haas is an American entity. So, there is nothing stopping Haas, an American company, from showing the Russian flag on their equipment if they choose to do so. So, WADA's investigation completely rides on whether or not they consider the American-owned car that Nikita is driving to be part of his personal equipment. If so, then we will likely see a livery change before winter testing begins. So, do you think the livery will be changed? Let me know in the comments down below. Personally, I don't like the look of the car, and I wouldn't mind the designers taking another crack at it. Thanks for hanging out, and consider subscribing for more Formula One content.